With a month to go until his corruption case, former President Jacob Zuma's legal team has dropped him. Mabuza attorneys have filed their intention to withdraw as his legal representatives with the High Court in Pietermaritzburg. So what are the implications for the prosecution of this withdrawal? The NPA says it's ready to go ahead, but will it actually happen? I'm joined now by Mpumelelo Zikalala from Zikalala Attorneys. Good evening, Mr. Zikalala. Thank you so much for your time. Do you think, bearing in mind how massive this trial is, that Zuma's legal team pulling out less than a month before it's due to start means a delay is inevitable?
Definitely, Sally. Good evening to you and good evening to the NSA listeners. Definitely. Probably the former president will come to court and say, I would love to participate in this process. I would love for the trial to start. However, I cannot do so with such a voluminous amount of legal jargon that I have to go through, legal documents that I have to go through, and the evidence that has been presented to me. I need a lawyer to represent me. I couldn't find one within the short space of time. Even if I could, they still need time to go and prepare. So if the trial is going to start in May, I may not be ready or I'm not ready. Please give me some time so that I can prepare adequately and be able to defend myself.
Why might a legal team pull out a month before such a massive trial? What are the sort of common reasons that you'd find?
The common reason would be, the first one, a difference of opinion in the legal strategy that must be followed in providing a defense. They may differ, where the client will then say, I'm not willing to accept the strategy that you are coming up with. I do believe there's another way in which we could be able to achieve the defense that we are looking for. Hence, I've lost confidence in the legal services or in the legal opinion that you are providing. The second reason could be that of money. So the client would then say, I don't have money to pay you anymore. It's quite expensive to have both advocate and instructing attorney to be at court. And you look at the number of days in which the matter has been set, it can easily set you back probably between, let's say, 15 and 20,000 rands per day. Now, the question would be, does the former president have that amount of money to spend in terms of legal fees? And if the answer is no, then definitely he would need definitely a sponsor, because even legal aid will not be able to come in these circumstances, because even legal aid has a certain criteria in which one has to qualify. So it is not a free-for-all type of service. There is a criteria that you must meet. And if you meet the means test, or if the means test is applied and then it is approved to you, then legal aid can then be provided to you. So there are a number of reasons that can come about, but the main two are the difference in opinion in terms of the defense that one must be, that the team would want to follow, or the second one would be legal fees.
All right. So we know, of course, that the Supreme Court of Appeal upheld a lower court's ruling that it wasn't right for the state to continue paying Jacob Zuma's legal fees. We know he's also got to pay back millions, we understand. It's interesting what you're saying, that legal aid will not be an option because there's a means test. Do you think that the former president has possibly a case to argue, well, I simply don't have any avenue. I don't have a sponsor who's going to pay my legal fees. The state's not prepared to pay, and I don't qualify for legal aid, so my constitutional right to a fair trial is being denied.
But then the question would be, don't you get any other income that is available to you? We know that the former president is on pension. Is there any money that he gets on a monthly basis? If there is, isn't there a certain legal practitioner that is there that could say, I could definitely take your matter on, you'll pay me maybe in installments, or I'll get the money in tranches rather than the full amount in a manner that we usually get paid in. So there are a number of options that are there, but what would be worrying is that all these concerns will have to be discussed now by the court, so that by the time the actual trial date is there, they have a clear picture or a clear direction of what is going to happen, because the worst thing would be to arrive on the day where the judge is expecting that the trial is going to continue, where the NPA is expecting that the trial is going to continue, and then you face all these problems that can't be solved in one day.
All right. Does it ever happen that a legal team withdraws its services as a delaying tactic?
It can happen, but you see, it's also a reputational type of element that you must take into account, because you must remember that it is the names of the legal practitioners that are at stake. So one wouldn't want to be seen as not being able to handle a matter in a professional manner. And you must also remember that as legal practitioners, we are accountable to the court. We are officers of the court. So our allegiance, in as much as we want to protect our clients as much as possible, we have to make sure that we don't hinder the process of the administration of justice at all costs. We also have to make sure that we are honest in our dealings with the court. So we'll then say, we are withdrawing in this case due to the following reasons. If the reasons are other than that of maybe your fees are not being paid anymore, or you have a difference of opinion, or simply the client is not willing to listen to your advice, then it is your duty as a legal practitioner to make sure that all those fears are allayed to, or they are dealt with before the actual trial starts, so that you avoid any unnecessary delay.
So at this point, the former president either needs to come up with the money himself or find someone who's prepared to sponsor him. Let's say he comes up with a plan. How long do you think a new legal team would need to get up to speed on such a big case?
Depending on the volume, but judging from what we've heard, I think a month would be enough. But let's remember that it's a month where that particular legal practitioner has already got other existing appointments, maybe other existing court dates that you would need to honor. So a month in terms of preparation would be enough. And then on the second month, then they could then say, we are ready to proceed. There may be an instance where they would say, we've reviewed the documents and the evidence received from the NPA. We still want to request further particulars pertaining to certain aspects. There's a different line of defense that you want to take, which is different from our predecessors. And we can't continue up until we have received that information. And that could add to further delays in terms of this matter actually starting.
Well, thank you so much for giving us so much important information. Really appreciate your time. That was Mpumelelo Zikalala from Zikalala Attorneys there.